about it, because we know only atmospheric condition, means atmosphere where we are having a diffusion radiation, beam radiation, and reflected from Earth. But this above your atmospheric limit, this is called extraterrestrial radiation. So we have some statement for that. The extraterrestrial radiation being outside the atmosphere, and that is not affected by changes in atmospheric condition. Why they are saying this? Atmospheric condition means sometimes it is cloudy, sometimes it is wind, rainy, is it? Sometimes it is a mixture combination. It will be looking like a sunny, but we are getting a rain. So, but these conditions will not affect your extraterrestrial atmospheric radiations. While passing through the atmosphere, it is subjected to the mechanism of atmospheric absorption and scattering depend upon atmospheric condition. So this is completely depend upon how your cloud is acting. Sometimes it is cloudy. So cloudy means the intensity of radiation which should reach the Earth will be absorbed by the cloud. And we can say direct radiation and diffusion radiation. Direct means whatever is given from the sun, it is directly received by the Earth. No other intermediate medias or dust or particles or any like cloud and all will not disturb. So that is for direct. But we will come to the second category of diffusion, because some will be absorbed, some will be scattered, and some rays will not reach the Earth directly. So that is diffusion part. So that's what they say, passing through the Earth atmosphere, passing through the Earth atmosphere, it is subjected to the mechanism of atmospheric absorption and the scattering depend upon atmospheric condition and depleting its intensity. Definitely, we should agree for this based on diffusion and direct radiation. Next, what do you mean by solar radiation? Solar radiation means final output, what we are getting. Let's see, the solar radiation that reaches the Earth surface after passing through atmospheric condition. See, I'm doing a final year one more subject called operation and maintenance solar electric system. So this can be related with the same subject. See here, how much radiation will reach based on standard or after atmospheric condition. That's what when designing this solar panels and all, people are having a standard condition where air mass we have to consider as a standard value 1.5, temperature 25 degrees Celsius, and at the same time irradiance of the solar has been considered as 1000 kilowatt per meter square. These are the standard condition we have to consider while designing any of the equipment for converting your solar energy into other forms of energy. So Earth reaches, means it reaches the Earth surface after passing through Earth atmosphere, is known as terrestrial radiation. And the term insulation, the solar insulation. Insulation means, as I said, how much time and how much area you are receiving the energy, and for that how much power you are getting. That says the term solar insulation. The term solar insulation or incident solar radiation is defined as the solar radiation received on a flat horizontal surface on the Earth. It is like your flux density, number of flux lines per unit area. So we call it as a flux density. Your solar insulation, you can call it as the number of radiation received per area, flat horizontal. Of course, you can't say vertical, horizontal. Huge area is required to receive the solar energy. So that says a term isolation. Sorry, insulation, not isolation, insulation. The next we'll go for spectral energy distribution of solar radiation. How it will be distributed, as we say, energy, solar energy will be available in the form of electromagnetic radiation, and that will be used in different cases. We'll see what is the spectral energy distribution. First point, the solar radiation covers a continuous spectrum of electromagnetic radiation in a wide frequency range. Definitely, as I said, radio waves are available, microwaves, and we know that speed of light we will always consider for calculating. And here, about 99% of the extraterrestrial radiation has wavelengths in the range of 0.2 to 4 micrometer, with maximum spectral intensity at 0.48. I mean, these are all like specialization of satellite people where they are given the data. Okay, so that we have to remember, 99% of the extraterrestrial radiations have wavelength in the range of 0.2 to 4 micrometer. What is the spectral intensity? That is 0.48 micrometer. Next, about 6.4% of extraterrestrial radiation energy is contained in the ultraviolet region. So ultraviolet region, okay, that is for 6.4% of extraterrestrial. Next, another one, 48% is contained in the visible region, means ultraviolet as well as visible. Ultraviolet, if you consider, that is 6.4. Another one is 48%. And the remaining comes under infrared region. So we are all familiar with the term called ultraviolet rays, visible rays, and as well as infrared rays. So if you consider what, how much percentage is contributing for the spectral energy, 6.4 from ultraviolet, 48 from visible, and 45.6 from the infrared region. Next, the point of view of terrestrial application of solar energy. So the radiation only in the range of wavelengths between 0.29 to 2.3 micrometer is significant. Means after, like in atmospheric region, whatever the energy we are getting, that is called terrestrial. And that application of radiations we are getting from, getting in the terms of wavelength between 0.29 to 2.3. And we people are very familiar with medical terms, X-rays, ultraviolet, ultra scanning, means where the and lens, they're operating the eyes by using the lens, like different rays technology, of course, right? So that technology is having a different wavelength, but you have to find out which one it should be suitable. X-ray. So X-ray is used for like scanning the body, like bones and all. Next, we have a CT scanning. So different are available. So we are using rays or light to get the output. So that's what they're given a wavelength as 0.29 to 23 micrometer, and we can consider this as a terrestrial application. So next, so this is one of the spectral solar irradiation and extraterrestrial terrestrial wavelength has been given here. So find out the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis is mainly for wavelength, different wavelengths. And the y-axis is representing solar irradiance distribution watt per meter square in micrometer. So we'll divide three cases. One is ultraviolet, second one is visible, the last one is infrared. So this three is applicable for both of the case of radiation, that is extraterrestrial as well as terrestrial. So we'll see the first waveform, upper one is for extraterrestrial, where huge output I'm getting in visible. That's what the percentage is worth more, 64. Similarly, terrestrial, if you consider, it is like visible also we are getting. So this is the point where it represents for terrestrial, second waveform, where the intensity or the peak value is less than your extraterrestrial. So again, the same contribution you can determine here, terrestrial region, visible light contribution is to the peak, and infrared is definitely we are using for almost all the application. And you can see the range of infrared, this is almost existing from a 0.8 to 2. So most of the region, infrared rays are giving an application in extraterrestrial, similarly on terrestrial portion. So next is depletion of solar radiation. Depletion means dividing, we can say separating, is it? So Earth atmosphere contains various gaseous constituents, suspended dirt and other minute solid and liquid particle matter, of course, which we are not seeing, just only we can feel it. Gas, different gases are available, dust will be there, solid particles also available and liquid particles also available. So then these are air molecules, ozone, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, water vapor, dust, water droplet. So these are all present, is it? Therefore, solar radiation is depleted during its passage through the atmosphere. See, so many contamination is there in all the forms which are available, gaseous form, solid form, is it? And air form, air gaseous both are same, liquid form. So all are available, solid is available, liquid is available, gaseous is available. So this is like a contamination. Definitely this contamination will affect the solar radiation. Next, absorption. So any of this contamination can affect the radiation of the system. Some of them are in a position to absorb the rays. Then selective absorption of various wavelengths occurs by different molecules. It means air will contribute to its own observation in different way. Gas will be in different way. Liquid will be in different way. Then the absorbed radiation increases the energy of the observing molecules, thus rises the temperature. So depending upon that, what it is observing, that matters a lot, so that it will go to affect the temperature of a system. So cloudy means we can assume air droplets, it is absorbed, so that I'm getting a cloudy nature. Our dust particles are absorbed more. Same way you can justify how the temperature is rising. Next, nitrogen, molecular oxygen, and the atmospheric gases absorb the X-rays and extreme ultraviolet radiation. So these gases are in a position to absorb X-ray and extreme ultraviolet radiation. Then ozone. Of course, ozone, we all know that ozone absorbs a significant amount of ultraviolet. Because see, for all the rays, if it hit the earth directly, and we are the living beings, normally people will say, so if you go outside, see, sunburn will happen, tan will happen. What is the tan? Burning of skin. Because some of the rays are not good for health. Definitely, if you stand in a sun for long hours, you'll change with the color. Your color will be changed. Why? Because the radiations are creating a problem on the skin. And some people, they will not go out itself, and they will face the health problems like the deficiency of vitamin C, deficiency of vitamin C. Normally, D is majorly for sun rays. So in that case, ozone layer, what is the main function? It tries to absorb, not try it. Of course, it will contribute for absorbing a significant amount of means. And that ultraviolet also, some are good for health. So it will take only the unwanted ultraviolet rays, that is a range of lambda less than 0.03 micrometer. Next one, water vapor and carbon dioxide, what it will absorb? Because we had so many contamination, gaseous form, liquid form, water form, is it? And water, what it will do? Water vapor and carbon dioxide, they're going to absorb almost completely the infrared radiation. It means these two, water and carbon, are in the place of absorbing the wavelength of 2.3 micrometer and deplete to some extent the near infrared radiation below this range. Means up to this 2.3, greater than 2.3 rays will be absorbed. Means this lambda value is going to specify which range of lambda values will be absorbed by the contaminations. Is it a ozone or water vapor or nitrogen? So water, it is greater than 2.3. Then next, dust particle and air molecules will also observe a part of a solar radiant energy irrespective of a wavelength. So dust particle, it is like, see, solar panel, let us assume, if over the surface of a solar panel, if the dust is occurred, what will happen to the efficiency of output? Definitely, see, it looks like a small dust which is not visible to us, but still that will going to reduce the efficiency of each cell. Input which is received by the cell will be definitely reduced because of a dust particle. Same way, irrespective of the wavelength, the like what intensity of light reaching the earth surface will be absorbed by the dust particles. Next, scattering. What is the scattering means? Just a minute. Scattering is just example. See, everyone will say to their parents, morning 7:30, mama, I'm going to college. So they will leave the house. They will take the pocket money from their parents. But I don't know. But if you come to the class for the attendance sake, you can find hardly 10 out of 20. What about the 10 members? They're scattered somewhere. So that is an example you can consider here. So scattering, you can consider as by dust particles and their air molecules involves redistribution of incident energy. Means whatever the rays are incidenting on the surface, that can be distributed. Already, first of all, you are getting from atmospheric air, and that is again, it is distributed to some of the friends like your dust particle and air molecules. So that they say redistribution of incident energy. Next, a part of the scattered radiation is lost to space. Lost to space. Space is nothing but what? You can say vacuum. And the remaining is redirected downwards to the earth surface from different direction is diffusion radiation. Diffusion means the, of course, 10 members have come to college, another 10, 5 are almost, they want to reach the college, but some are there. Some remaining 5 is there. But they said, hey, why you want to go for first class? Yeah, solar and wind is completely theory subject. We can read. Come, we'll go to canteen. They are scattering those people, right? So this is an example of diffusion radiation. Then, okay, the question will always, we are asking, sky means always painting and people will go with the blue color. We were not knowing what was the reason. Because your scattered sunlight, it will make your sun to look in a, sorry, sky to look in a blue color. Because the radiations which are coming out of the sun are in a different colors. As we know, white color panel is lit up into waveguide, different colors. So we'll have red color, violet color, blue color, green color. So blue color will be going to be present most of the time. So that's what your sky will look like. In a cloudy atmosphere, a major part of the incoming solar radiation is reflected back into the atmosphere by clouds. It means it is taken. So see, if your summer reason is summer season, but suddenly rain has come, you can see the temperatures, like it will be completely goes down. But if it rains for a longer period, you will get a cold nature. But if not, just for 10 minutes or 20 minutes, if it comes and go, humidity of the sun, like humidity of the area will go into increase. This is like in a cloudy atmosphere, a major part of the incoming solar radiation is reflected back into the atmosphere by clouds. So normally if you go to the seaside, beach side, see, this is a water area.